We really want to be aware of the energy in our water systems, as this has a direct impact on the cost to operate our system. If we can deliver the same level of service to our customers with less energy, the savings would add up. So in this video, I show you one way to visualize the potential and kinetic energy in a single pipeline. If we want to visualize the potential energy of a system, then we need to draw in the hydraulic grade line, or HGL. This line represents the amount of energy, potential energy, at any point along a given pipeline. Without flowing in any direction, the potential energy is captured by the elevation of the pipe, as well as the pressure head P over gamma in the pipeline. How do we represent this on a design drawing? We start by drawing in a profile view of a pipeline. A pipeline profile is a side view of the pipeline beneath the ground. This allows us to view the vertical alignment of a pipeline, which is to say that we can see the elevation of the pipeline more clearly. This gives us a view of one of the key elements of the HGL. In this example, we're going to start our lateral pipeline from this existing 48-inch diameter pipe. And between our existing and our final destination, we have to go around another existing pipeline. So the alignment of our pipeline roughly parallels the existing ground line, but has to jog beneath the larger pipeline. I'll add in these tick lines to show the pipe joints and label the start and end of the visualization with the labels for points 1 and 2. Representing the HGL on this profile view begins with drawing in the amount of potential energy at the start of our lateral pipeline, which is the elevation up to the center of the pipeline and the pressure head in the pipeline. At the other end, we label the same. I draw similar lines representing the elevation and pressure at 2, but this time the Z plus P over gamma is less than at point 1. And that is due to, big surprise coming, friction! We lose some of the potential energy in the pipeline as water flows from point 1 to point 2, and this difference in energy is called head loss. Surprisingly, this term has nothing to do with Marie Antoinette. But it does tell us that there were losses due to friction, which we refer to as the major losses. There is another general category of head loss in the pipeline, and we refer to these as minor losses in a pipeline. And they happen at any points where the lines of fluid in the pipeline change direction or are obstructed in any way. So we can now conceptually add the start of the HGL to the pipeline by simply guessing the rate at which energy is lost in the pipeline due to friction. The rate that we lose energy is also known as the friction slope, and this is a very important term in hydraulic analysis. This we label as the major losses, and then where there are fittings or changes in direction in the pipeline, we represent that with a vertical line going down to show the minor losses. We complete the HGL by filling in the rest of the major losses and minor losses as shown here. Now we can consider what happens when the fluid in the pipe begins to move from point 1 to 2, and we start to see the presence of kinetic energy in our system. For this, we need to draw the energy grade line, or EGL. This is computed as the velocity head, or V squared over 2G term in our system. This energy exists in addition to the potential energy. We also represent it as being above the HGL line. If the diameter of the pipeline is not changing, and if the flow rate is not changing, then the velocity must be constant over the length of the pipeline. That means that the V squared over 2G term does not change, and we call this steady uniform flow conditions. And since the velocity is not changing, then the energy grade line, or EGL, is parallel to the hydraulic grade line. Now, some students get hung up for a minute when they see the pipe slope up as it's going in the direction of flow, and they might be tempted to think, shouldn't the energy also increase? If the elevation is increasing, then isn't the potential energy as well? The elevation is increasing, but the total energy does not, because the pressure head is decreasing. Imagine that somewhere nearby but far away enough off this page, there is a reservoir or tank at a fixed elevation that is supplying the pressure head to our pipeline here. As the pipeline increases elevation, the fluid in the pipe gets closer to the source of energy in the system, so the pressure decreases at the same rate that the elevation increases. So basically no change due to the rising and falling of the pipeline. In the end, what does the HGL tell us in the real world, not just on some stupid drawing? Well, it tells us that if we poke a hole in the top of the pipe, then we can assume water will squirt up to the height of the HGL, or just below it if we're accounting for a minor loss as the fluid exits the pipe and the resistance encountered by the soil or air above the pipeline. The EGL can be similarly visualized if we were to stick a tube into the middle of the pipeline where the velocity of the water is flowing. And this will result in water squirting higher in the air up to the EGL line.